automatically and intuitively, in some bizarre cosmic way, directed towards opiates. And, you know, the same thing happens, it always happens. You're gonna be with somebody at some time and somebody's gonna get busted. And whether it was a blessing in disguise, I don't know, maybe it was. But it's ironic though that I came to Duff, you know, about a week and a half before I got arrested.
Scott came to me and he knew that I got sober through martial arts. He said, look, man, I've been to rehab 32 times or whatever, and obviously it's not working.
Yeah, because I'd given the traditional ways 200% tries, 100% tries, 300% tries, 50% tries, a lot of tries. Not to say that I haven't had success. I had almost 2 years sober through those traditional 12-step ways. But something needed to be different this time. Duff has electricity about him, this light, this power, this strength, this serenity, and I wanted what he had.
I said, if I make the call for you, it's gotta be, you gotta go in 100%, you know? And he did.
Get the centrifugal force going. Careful on my shoulder.
So deflecting punches, right, left, right. No, straight. It's straight. Right. Yeah. You don't look. Right. So one,
two, three. Nice. Just like that. And have that elbow come right around this angle here. Go ahead. Nice. That's it.
One, two, three. Pull. That's it. Now you're scaring me. Cool stuff.
Great stuff. Like everyone knows, you know, I fell into the trap of heroin addiction. It just took some time for the negative consequences to pile up. The best is yet to come because I no longer will have to hide from those demons. I'll just kick the out of them. Simple.
Collectively as a band, we all love Scott so much. We put our eggs into one basket, and that's a scary thing to do. Going back to the drawing board seemed like a really dark thing to have to do. But the most important thing is just hoping that all this effort is actually going to pay off for him in his own life, you know?
On some websites and that kind of thing about the band's ability to make it in the long run with what happened a couple of weeks ago with Scott. You know, can you give fans some assurance that the band is going to have some longevity?
We all, you know, the thing about this band is there's a common thread, and it relates to all of our past. We're real, you know, and what happens is real. Scott a couple weeks ago, you know, really could have happened to any one of us. It has happened to all of us.
There's, you know, tons of people out there that sort of want to knock Scott down, and we're such the underdogs that we want to see it the other way. So no matter what anybody says, you know, about him, as long as, you know, he comes through on his end, as we'll back him up all the way. To do anything that's difficult properly, you have to, you know, you have to get behind it.
All of us knew our potential. We had rehearsed together, we had recorded together, we'd hung out together, we'd been through all kinds of other stuff together, but we hadn't played live together. How are we going to be on stage together? Everything was very intense leading up to it. I think we reverted to kind of the most primal thing, you know, getting ready for that gig, which was the intensity of like the martial art training. It wasn't spoken, we just kind of did it. Sounded great. You know, we got up on stage and it just sounded amazing. But I do remember looking over a couple times at Scott, like seeing him roll across the floor and diving into the audience. Man, this guy's an animal.
Comfortable once it started, yeah. Everybody was in their pocket and everybody was covering their shit. It was just cool.
But it wasn't really until after the gig, you know, that we realized the chemistry was complete. So we knew now we could move on and make our record and be a band.